Hi guys, welcome back to my channel and thank you for watching this video. I hope that you're all doing amazing today. In July, over 30 Ryanair passengers were treated in a hospital and some were bleeding from their ears. So what happened? Their airplane lost cabin pressure and the pilots executed an emergency descent. I will explain what happens during a loss of pressurization, and I'll try to do so in a way that everybody can understand this. So the reason why you're still alive at an altitude of 38,000 feet is because the cabin of the airplane is pressurized during all phases of flight. Simply put, it works like this. There's more air in than out. First, we need to discuss the bleed air. Bleed air is hot air taken from the compressor section of the engine, which is supplied to the air conditioning system. The air conditioning system treats the air and supplies it to the cabin. That way, the passengers and everybody has air coming in. To pressurize the air, the pressurization system controls the amount of air leaving the airplane. And this is achieved by controlling the outflow valve and the overboard exhaust valve. These valves are literally little doors in the airplane structure, which automatically close when a higher pressure is needed inside the cabin. Of course, to reduce the cabin pressure, the door opens, allowing more air to go out. And without a pressurized cabin and without supplementary oxygen, an average person will lose his or her consciousness within 30 seconds at an altitude of 38,000 feet. So that's very quick. Whenever there is a loss of pressurization due to, for example, a hole in the fuselage or a system failure, you will notice that the oxygen masks will automatically drop. This will happen at any altitude above 14,000 feet. Your passenger oxygen will only last about 12 minutes, which means that in case of an uncontrollable cabin altitude, an emergency descent should be made to 10,000 feet or at least the minimum terrain clearance, in order for everyone to breathe normally without the need of supplementary oxygen. So what do the pilots do at the moment a loss of pressurization is noticed? As soon as a cabin exceedance or a cabin altitude configuration warning horn sounds and the cabin altitude light illuminates, we don the oxygen mask and set the regulators to 100%. In that way, we receive 100% oxygen. We set the microphone to mask and establish crew communications. We select the pressurization mode selector to manual and we hold the outflow valve switch in close until the indicator shows fully closed. Whenever the cabin altitude after these items is not controllable, we select the passenger signs on, and as the cabin altitude is about to exceed 14,000 feet, we select the passenger oxygen switch on as well. We perform an emergency descent, which is a very steep descent, in order to go down as soon as possible. During the emergency descent, the captain will call emergency descent over the PA or intercom 3 times. We descend to 10,000 feet, select 45 degrees to the left or right, and we retard the thrust levers. We deploy the speed brakes and select VMO or MMO, the maximum operating airspeed. In the meantime, the pilot monitoring selects the engine start switches to continuous and sets the transponder to 7700 and TA only. After that, he or she calls ATC. The call will be something like Mayday, 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 Alpha Bravo Charlie 123, rapid depressurization, heading 245, altitude 12,000 feet, request QNH. We select the turn off lights on and set the local QNH, the ones which we just got from ATC, and grab and complete the non-normal checklist. Whenever we are level again, we select a lower airspeed and remove the oxygen masks, or at least one of us, first. Then we talk to the number one, or purser, in order to check how everybody is doing. We check the fuel and talk to ATC. We then evaluate the situation, make a decision, execute the decision, and perform a NITS briefing to our colleagues in the cabin. The NITS briefing is a short briefing to let the number one know what's going on and what we're going to do. The N from NITS stands for nature of the problem, I stands for intentions, T for time before landing, and S for specials. In case we as pilots have time, we perform a PA to the passengers to let you guys know what just happened. But it is simply the last priority in a situation like that. So in general, this is what happens in the cabin and cockpit during a loss of pressurization. I hope you have a better understanding now of why you should put your oxygen masks over your nose and mouth and breathe normally. Check out my website dutchpilotgirl.com for for many aviation and pilot career related content. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. I hope to see you in the next video, guys. Bye bye.